Hey, yo, what's up, family? This is Daddy Yankee, and you're watching Boston Latino TV, the big boss, talento de barrio.
You know who I am.
There is an outstanding aspect in Ramon Ayala's activities that I want to highlight tonight. His engagement with public service and community building through philanthropic work. In my view, this aspect makes him a person and an artist with a distinctive, remarkable profile to deserve to be the recipient of the Harvard Latino of the Year Award. Through the Corazon Guerrero Foundation and through other socially oriented initiatives, Ramon Ayala or Daddy Yankee demonstrates a deep engagement with local communities and young people. In this sense, what he does is philanthropy, philanthropy in the most classical sense of the term. In Daddy Yankee, there is an artist, but also there is a person with deep social and cultural values. Here, I'm speaking about the socially sensitive human being who is Ramon Ayala, the Harvard Latino of the Year Award.
Very hard to get me nervous, but I'm a little nervous now. I've been in front of thousands of people, but this is a special moment for me. Cause, you know, there's a real life out there, you know, that en verdad mucha gente está, sorry man, soy bien sentimental. Sorry man. Lo que digo es que hay una vida allá afuera que mucha gente quizás no sabe lo que hay y hay mucha necesidad. And honestly, I just want to say thank you to Presencia Latina, and I want to dedicate this to all the students here. You know why? Because you're the future of your country. You know, there's a big responsibility. I know that you come here like to fight for your family, but let me tell you that it's bigger than that, you know? Probably you're gonna be the next lawyer that might be representing your country. Probably you might be the next president of your country. You know, so no te olvides de tus raíces. Don't forget where you come from. Stay true to yourself. Y tú vas a ver que you could be a great leader for your family and for your people. Así que se lo dedico a ustedes que son el futuro de su nación.
Hi, I'm here with Marisa. She's the director of Presencia Latina. I'm also with Kenny. Yeah. He put together all this because he's the producer of Presencia Latina. I know, I don't want to give him all the credit because if not, Marisa's going to kick me. But guys, you put together an amazing, amazing event. This made us all proud of just being Latino. How difficult is it to put something like this together?
Yeah, I mean, extremely difficult, especially for us. We're a student organization. We don't have the financial resources. It's something we... Without money, it's something that we couldn't do.
Marisa, tell me a little bit about Why did you pick Daddy Yankee? Why him? How did you find out about all the work that he's done with the community?
Well, when we were looking for a candidate for the award this year, he was just, you know, the top of the list because of the work he's done with the youth especially, and that's the message we want to promote with Presencia Latina. You know, here at the college, we have so many prominent Latino organizations, and our goal is to reach out to the youth and bring them up with us, you know. And he's just a great example of someone in the mainstream society who has done that. So.
Wow. We're looking for an example to follow, a young professional Latino who's also giving back to the community. And that's like something that we'd like to follow when we graduate.
Wow.
And have our own careers.
I just found out, because I gotta be honest, I didn't know that there are a lot of Latino organizations within Harvard.
Yeah.
And I don't know if they all heard from someone like Daddy Yankee here. Not trying to make any trouble for them, but it's how does this work? How do you guys work together? Is any organization work differently, separately? How does it work?
Well, there's a lot of organizations. There's 8 prominent organizations on campus, as well as professional groups and performance groups that you will see in the show. But it just takes a lot of cooperation. You know, we have events 2, 3, 4 days a week that we all attend. It's a growing community. We just admitted another 200 Latino students this year for class of 2012. So, you know, we just have to work together. And, you know, this event especially, it's, you know, the cooperation of all those groups. Every performer, you know, in the show is a part of that group. We have helpers, you know, working in the background. And without them, like, none of this could have been possible.
I always think about is Harvard is like as an institution, it's hundreds of years old, but this is only the 6th annual Presencia Latina. I think about it, it's been around for such a long time that only now Latinos actually have a presence on campus, and that's something important that we want to continue to leave a mark and make sure that our voices are heard.
My family asks questions in Spanish and answers them in English. Hola, goodbye, king to the pasa, mi gente.
Mi gente, passing traditions through umbilical cords like whispered secrets. 3 generations in the kitchen making tortillas. My grandmother with healing hands that rubbed empachos into health. My mother with a stern look that moved mountains to sweep the floors and wash the dishes. And a 7-year-old version of me making lopsided attempts at the Aztec calendar shapes they were so effortlessly making.
My people, to be Latino is to cross borders every day, and it don't matter where you're from. To be Latino is to be asked to talk about being Latino to other Latinos.
Daddy Yankee was recognized as Latino of the Year by Harvard. So Paya, tell me a little bit about the experience that we just had here.
Yeah, it was great to have Daddy Yankee come here. Hearing his story from his own words was very inspirational. Having him tell us, you know, what he thinks of the stereotypes of Latinos or the culture of being a Latino man and sharing that with others was very interesting and fun for us.
So tell me, do you like reggaeton?
Oh, I love, me encanta reggaeton.
Like managing a very complicated stuff upstairs, mechanical stuff. What was it? What is your role here?
I'm the soundboard. I do soundboard for this show. I've done soundboards for another show. I also DJ, so basically sound is my department. I was doing the cues, the music, so that was me.
And you lost the mic.
And the mic, and I lost the mic.
And we need one of those. I mean, if you get to thickness to stuff, you're gonna find
but
it.
But see, this is the thing. If you knew about technology, you would know that you can't just take the mic; you would take the receiver. So if you happen to know where the mic is, so I can tell you where the receiver is. You know.
So you feel that it's different if you speak Spanish, or if you don't speak Spanish and you consider yourself Latino?
Yeah, definitely. I think it falls deeper than that because, like I said, there's other Brazilians. You know, eu falo um pouquinho de português.
Now he's showing off.
I'll stop. But yeah, definitely it's all about the roots and the struggle. It's the history. You know, you might have grown up with tortillas and called them something else. Just because you didn't use the word Spanish word tortilla, it can't take away, you know, being yelled at, praying to the Virgen. It's all there, you know, if the Spanish is missing, the rest will carry you on.
No, I am older, not that much, just a little bit. Older than Alan. And he just taught me a lot.
Hey, saludo a Kaya de parte de Daddy Yankee, baby. Te quiero mucho, mama. Saludo, baby. The big boss. You know?